Hey everybody, me and Dean back at you with another video today. Today we are doing episode 3 of BC versus the world. I have an interesting one for you today, we'll see. I'm not going to do my wife's going to come in and switch them this time. I'm just going to drink them as is because she's asleep. It's nap time. And I don't want to wait for her, so, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and throw my own glass here. So today, we're doing Bordeaux blends. And what we have for you is 2014 Hypothesis from Culmina Family Winery, Family Estate Winery, and they're in, well, the Golden Mile Bench, which in the Okanagan Valley, which is what this one is. And we're going down under. Put a little shrimp on the bobby. No, I'm sorry, I'll never do that again. Derenberg 2014, the Galvo Garage, Bordeaux blend. $50 from the winery. This one was $34.99, but I probably had it for 2 or 3 years. You probably pay $40-ish for it now. I'm not sure. Private liquor store. But, okay. So what these wines have in common are two things. They're both 2014, they're both Bordeaux blends. That's really all. Well, they're both Cab Sauv heavy Bordeaux blends. But the percentages are quite different. This one here, the Galvo Garage, Cab Sauv 54%. 23% Merlot, and here's the shocker, 23% Petit Verdot. Now, you're not going to find a lot of Bordeaux blends with 23% Petit Verdot in them. This one here has no Petit Verdot, in fact. It's got 45% Cab Sauv, 33% Merlot, 22% Cab Franc. Now, I must say, when I put my nose in the glass here, I immediately thought, Malbec. Oh, that smells like Malbec, and there's absolutely no Malbec in it at all. So, giving a nice swirl. But they've been open for a little while, so they have had time to breathe. The Galvo Garage, leather, a little bit of forest floor, blackberry, like blackberry jam, which is what made me think of the Malbec. It's not overly jammy, but jammy enough that it could be Malbec. And then you've got some dark chocolate, some graphite pencil shavings. It's intense. There's some baking spice there, definitely some cinnamon, clove, nutmeg, cardamom. It smells like a beast. It's 7 years old, I'm assuming it's gonna settle down now. But let's try that first. We'll try Australia first. Whoa. Oh, that is delicious. Ooh. Wow. Boy, I put BC in another tough spot, didn't I? That's lovely. It's everything I said was on the nose, on the palate, too. There's a little bit of mint coming through. I'm just going to see how long it finishes while I read the, I was going to read about the oak. There's definitely some new French oak here. Here it is. Basket pressed and transferred to a mixture of new and old French oak to complete fermentation and mature for 18 months. So this is not, I don't want to give you the impression this is a huge oak bomb. It's not like a, you know, 93 Camus California Cab or one of those things that's been oaked, you know, I mean oaked. Yeah, really delicious. Just Petit Verdot. It's bringing such an interesting structure. 23% Petit Verdot. I mean, it's just, you know, you look at the percentages on a Bordeaux blend, it's usually 2, maybe 3. And if they go crazy, you get 10% Petit Verdot, 23. This is from McLaren Vale and Adelaide Hill. So obviously they're getting some of the grapes from both places. Generally, McLaren Vale, I think, is more where this comes from. But anyway, I can highly recommend this baby. Seven years of age is as fresh as the day it was bottled. Tannins are still medium plus. Acidity's medium plus. Alcohol's medium plus. What is the alcohol? 14.5, yeah. It's a nice bottle of wine. All right, let's see if Canada can equal or topple it. 2014, Hypothesis, this is their big Bordeaux blend, or I guess it's their signature wine, I guess. Although I must say, much as I like all of Culmina's wines, my favorites of theirs are always the, most of the whites, the Gruner, makes a good Chardonnay, the Rosé is usually spectacular. The reds have not quite lived up to some of the whites for me, some of them, but, all right. This is, even after being open a while, this one's still really closed. A nice browny tint, lots of separation of meniscus. Goes a little bit orange at the end, you might expect from a 7-year-old wine. There's a little bit of blackberry there. Black pepper. Wow, quite a bit of black pepper. Like a charcuterie, the grilled meats. The clove. Cease. All right, let's see how it goes. Well, nothing wrong with that one either. So a lot of black fruit, very fruity again, 7 years old, a lot of black fruit. Chocolate, mint, a little more mint in this one than in this one, which makes sense. There's some Cab Franc and Cab Sauvignon here. What did I say, 22% Cab Franc? A little eucalyptus or mint. Definitely some evidence of new French oak here. I wonder how much French oak they use. Not as much as this one, though. But some vanilla, baking spice, 33% Merlot. This one was 27% Merlot. No, 23. Sure, breaking glass. 23% Merlot. All right, so, yeah. So had the wife come in and done her switchy-switchy thing or not, I would have been able to guess which one of these was which without any trouble. They don't smell anything like it at all. Both very good wines. But there's no question in my mind that the Canada's has gone down 2-1. Structure similar. Not as, this is more structured, but yeah, medium plus tannins. Still a little grippy. Medium plus alcohol. Probably about 14.5%, something like that, 14 even. Alcohol seems very similar. Well, it's 0.5%, that's not a huge deal, obviously. Yeah, both very good wines, but Australia wins this one by quite a bit. I would recommend this wine, I absolutely would. If you haven't had Culmina's Reds, by all means try them. There's some really good stuff there. Culmina's Whites especially. If you like Gruner Veltliner, it's the best Gruner Veltliner in BC. And I've had a few of them, but nothing's close. They have good Riesling, good Chardonnay, lots of good whites, rosés, spectacular year after year. The reds are also very good. This, however, though, if you're not familiar with Derenberg, you can see the red stripe on all their bottles. That's kind of their trademark. You can go into almost any liquor store in BC, probably anywhere. Wherever you're watching this, you probably go into a liquor store and find these bottles. Derenberg exports a lot of their wine, and I don't think they're ever had a bad one. They're really lovely. This is, I believe, the first time I've ever had this particular bottle, but I will get it again next time I see it because it's delicious. And 23% Petit Verdot is really something else. It really brings a lot of structure and intensity. It's a velvety mouthfeel. Really a good wine. So that's that for now. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I'll be posting a new wine blog coming up too. I continued my Okanagan trip report. That's coming up in the next day or so. And I'm going to go enjoy the rest of these wines, especially this one. I can't wait. I'm going to bury that one. It'll be gone before I close the door. Wow. That's beautiful. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a comment if you enjoyed it, or if you didn't. Tell me why. What else you want me to see? This BC versus the world series I'm doing. I got quite a few other ideas. Did a little shopping yesterday, picked up a few more bottles from other places than BC. So I might have some more good suggestions coming up. But until then, that's all for now. Don't forget to drink great wine. See you next time. Thanks, everybody.